Yes, I have.
Oh, okay. Go on then.
I would like to be coached about my weight, which I know is really personal,
yeah.
But it is one of the biggest things at the moment.
Okay.
Come on, no pun intended.
So this question could use some distress.
Yes.
What, too much, too little? Shape, size?
Too much weight. Not that bothered about shape really, but it's just now causing, well, it's fitness, not specifically fitness, it's the heaviness. Feeling uncomfortable. I've got a hip replacement as well, so that kind of doesn't help.
Okay. So it's making you feel uncomfortable?
Yeah.
Okay. What would make you feel comfortable?
If I lost about 4 stone.
Okay. And how long would it take you to lose that amount of weight?
In the past, when I've gone on stupid diets, I have lost that weight probably in about 5 or 6 months.
Okay, all right. Okay, so by spring, that could be a name.
Could be.
To be a comfortable size and shape.
Yes.
By spring.
Yes.
And what would that mean to you?
It would mean that I would find it easier to exercise.
Okay.
Obviously, I've got stupid foot problems and everything, which are exacerbated by being too heavy. And it would also mean that the reason I lost weight before I was successful was because I had a goal.
Okay.
And that was so that I could ride my young horse.
Okay. So a goal is important to you, more than just feeling comfortable.
A goal is quite important, yes. Yes.
Would you need more than just feeling comfortable?
I think having something that I'm aiming towards that actually means an awful lot to me could be useful.
And that's something, so it's really interesting because what I'm hearing is that actually feeling comfortable and aiming it for yourself isn't as important as doing it for some other external reason.
If I did it for my horse again,
yeah,
that's kind of for myself. I used to compete.
Yeah, it's not as much for your horse.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
But I would be a better rider.
Okay, so for your horse,
yeah,
not for you necessarily.
Okay.
Okay, but have you got something that could substitute the fact? Because you're not going to get another horse, are you?
No.
Okay. So is it the same horse in terms of?
It's the same horse. Yeah.
Okay. And what would that look like in terms of success?
I would be a better rider, my balance would be better. I wouldn't feel so self-conscious.
Okay.
Flopping around.
Right.
I would probably be safer.
And okay.
The horse probably would be more comfortable.
Okay. What's stopping you then?
Well, I'm stopping myself.
Okay. Do you know why?
No, because I like food.
Okay. Well, yeah. We need food.
Yeah.
Okay. So what is it about food? Is it a quantity thing or a quality thing?
No, not really. I just eat the wrong... I know that I eat the wrong things.
Mm-hmm.
So, chocolate.
Okay.
Subway. Road.
Yeah, it doesn't help having one down the road,
doesn't.
Does it?
It doesn't, no.
Yeah, but nobody's forcing us to go there.
No,
we choose to go there.
I know. Also, it's, you know, it can be boring.
Okay.
And you know, I want to be able to eat what I want to eat.
Okay, right. But maybe it's a quantity thing, maybe it's a quality thing.
Yeah.
Because we now know that Subways are not good for us.
No.
Too much sugar.
Absolutely.
Okay, so there'll be a switch somewhere that we need to find,
yes,
which helps you make that adjustment,
yeah,
to be able to take more control.
Yeah.
So where do you think we could find that switch? What could we do in the short term to start trying to find where the switch is?
I can have a look at the sorts of things that I eat.
Okay.
And try and find better alternatives.
So we could look at, we could start by doing a diagnostic. We could keep a record of what you eat. And perhaps keep a list. And when?
Okay.
And could you do that for me? And the next time we meet, we could actually do a review and actually see what you eat, when you eat. And how about putting a mood category across that? How are you feeling when you eat?
Yeah.
Would you be able to keep that?
Yep.
What, for the next 7 days?
Okay.
And then we'll review that. That's something we could do.
Okay.
That'll give us information that we could work on.
Okay.
So, like a mood food thing.
Mood food thing.
Is that okay?
Yes.
You keep a list. And how are you feeling at the time?
Okay.
When I say keep a list, you know, what did you eat? And how are you feeling? When you, you know, so we actually know what you consume.
So what I ate and how I was feeling when I was eating it?
Yeah.
What about how I was feeling before I was eating it? And how I was feeling after I was eating it?
Do you want to do two columns, eh?
Oh my God.
Well, right here, but why?
I know! This is what I mean though, you just pull stuff out of
me. Well, I'm just saying, it's your idea. I think that would be a really great idea.
Yeah.
Okay, so just for 7 days, because it will become more consuming. A mood, how are you feeling before and after you've eaten, and what you ate, and when you ate it?
Okay.
That would give us some information, wouldn't it?
Okay.
So
what would happen then if I then start to think, hang on a second, I don't want to eat what I'm about to eat, would I put that too?
Well, you wouldn't be eating it, so you wouldn't be on there, would it? You only keep a record of what you eat, because actually you're not gaining weight by not eating stuff, are you? You're gaining weight by eating stuff, so actually, let's have a look at what's giving you the weight rather than what's not.
Okay.
Maybe we can come back to that.
Okay.
But I take your point. Why is your foot stupid?
My foot?
Yeah.
Just because the whole of my biomechanics of my body has changed and twisted.
Okay.
Since I've had my
So it's working dysfunctionally.
So it is.
Why is it stupid?
Well, it's not stupid, it's just...
Well, you can call it stupid.
I know, but it annoys me.
Okay.
And stupid things annoy me.
Okay. So you get annoyed.
I get annoyed.
Okay. Who annoys you most in the whole world?
Me.
What annoys you about you?
I don't know.
You don't
know. What annoys me about me? Lots of things.
Okay. We've come up to 7 minutes.
Mm.
Right. We've come very quickly. But one of the things I'd like to work on is. Things that make you sad and make you annoyed about you.
Mm.
Right, this is going to be quite easy because you know me quite well.
Yeah.
But I think we need to do some diagnostic about what is it about you that actually annoys you.
Yeah.
Because unless we know what's annoying you, we can't actually sort that out. So what we could possibly do between now and the next time we meet, which will be in 7 days, which we will be having in 7 days, is we could review a food chart, a mood food chart, before and after with your mood. And maybe you could just keep a reflective journal in terms of the subject being what annoys me about me.
Mm.
And then next time we meet, we can have a conversation about it.
Yeah. I think I know what annoys me about me. I'm just thinking about
myself. What? Because you said you didn't know.
Well, I do.
Well, then. just for completion.
Yeah, and actually, it's not, it's quite a good thing. And then it can be the flip side of that and be quite a bad thing. Anything that I worry about,
yeah,
I don't worry about it. And I just put it to the back of my head until it actually happens.
So you're a bit of procrastination, a bit of denial?
I think it's just denial and then when it happens. But then that's a good thing because when I worry about something, I don't feel very, I feel poorly again.
But putting all that stuff behind you, it's not going away, is it? It's just coming and actually it's going in almost like a metaphorical rucksack and it's weighing you down. You might need to unpack that rucksack. Well, not now, but maybe if we do keep that reflective journal to actually try and identify what stuff is annoying you in terms of the stuff that's going in that rucksack, that will give us something to talk about next time.
Yes.
Happy to do that?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay.
As long as I haven't got an audience.
Or some video. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Happy?
Yeah.